Clemson. Where is your brother?
It's in, I think, Soweto.
We need to set your brother free.
Okay.
You hear me?
Yes.
Your brother is living in a bondage.
You know,
I see that he has been trying to make life for himself.
Yes.
But things are very difficult. You hear me?
Yes.
And I saw a business he wanted to do.
Yes.
So, but nothing is working out. After I pray for you, go and tell your brother that something is coming.
Okay.
You hear me?
Yes.
This spirit at home is going to leave you people.
Okay.
In Jesus' name.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Viewers all over the world, welcome to Charis Missionary Church. This is our Sunday live service under the leadership of Apostle JB and Prophetess T.E. Makananisa. And with me here today is my brother, who was located during the service by Prophet Andres Semono, who ministered upon his life. Sir, kindly please tell us your name and tell us where you come from.
Sambani Mangani from Boxburg.
Today during the service, Prophet Andres Semono located you and he ministered upon your life. Please tell us in details what he said to you and please confirm it.
He actually told me about the brother who is struggling, who is staying in Soweto. And then he has been trying to start the business, but it hasn't been working. So today he just told me, after the prayer that I've received, his business will come to pass. Amen.
And so how do you feel that today the man of God located you and ministered upon your life, speaking about your brother?
I actually feel good because I know my brother doesn't even go to church. So this is something that has been always wanting. No.
And how would you encourage somebody who's going to come across this video?
To keep the faith. With the faith, everything around you can work well. Yes.
You're free. If you forgive these people of your in-laws,
yes, man, of course.
Let's allow Jesus to fight your battles.
Amen.
You hear me?
Amen.
Sometimes we delay ourselves because we cannot forgive.
Amen.
So forgive these people.
I forgive them.
And I want to tell you, after you forgive them, you'll see all these issues of the property of your husband.
Yes.
They'll be sorted.
I thank you.
First thing that you must do, forgive these people.
I forgive them.
You know, for the battle that they've given you. You've been homeless, you had problems.
Yes.
But I want you to forgive them. From there, Jesus will bring you a solution.
Amen.
You're free. You're free.
Ma, please tell us your name and tell us where you come from.
My name is Alice Mafasi Pitsi. I'm from Fort Lauderdale.
Today during the service, my Prophet Andres located you and he ministered upon your life. I'd love that you please tell us in details what he said to you and please confirm it.
Okay, he confirmed what I came to testify about this morning. I testify about the goodness of God and concerning my late husband's properties, which has been confiscated by my in-laws. And I took the case to court. The case has been dragging on since 2013, 2014, up to now. So I got tired. I really got tired because even the lawyer, which was handling my case, absconded. And his senior, when I approached his senior said, okay, sign more papers, and then I will follow it up. Last year, at the beginning of May, in December, when I called him to find out how the case is proceeding, he just said, he doesn't care. He doesn't care. He said, he's exciting COVID, he said, he's making many excuses. But I came here for one-on-one with Prophet Andres, and he prayed for my papers, which I took to the law society. Within it's hardly a month, things are moving, and I believe my cry is over. It is over. And then he encouraged me. Prophet encouraged me to forgive. And I forgive those children. It's not even adults. So by coming here, really, really, this is a place of liberty, place of possibilities. And in Jesus' name, I thank God for the prophet who touched my life, and things are really changing. Amen.
Let me touch you. When you grew up, you saw people performing very bad things at home.
Amen.
You saw people performing rituals.
Amen.
At home. And I want to tell you, you have done well by taking, you know, your life to Christ.
Amen.
This will set your children free.
Amen.
You hear me?
Amen.
Because I saw you when you were coming up growing, and you saw a lot of people in the family performing very strong rituals.
Amen.
So now Jesus has set you free.
Amen.
And I believe even your children, they'll be free.
Amen.
Marriage must come now.
Amen.
They are your children.
Yes, all of them. Mm.
All of them. Mm. I'm saying marriage must come now.
Amen. I receive.
You know, they must break the curse that was on you.
Amen.
I'm sure you're hearing me.
I know.
You know what I'm telling you is true.
Amen.
What you saw growing up, the family was a very wicked family. I'm sorry to tell you that.
It's true.
Yeah?
Amen.
So now, let's break this curse. It must not come to your children.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Come out. Come out. Hurry. Let me touch you. You come here. You must pray for your breast. You hear me?
Yes.
Touch here. You demon of cancer, come out. Come out! Ari, come out, you demon! Out! Out! I won't focus on one line, I'll just mix you up like this. Out! Lift her up. Mama, there's something here. This will affect your breasts because it's like a pain.
Yes.
You hear
yes,
me?
It's true.
Huh?
Yes, it's true.
This will affect your breast.
Yes.
Soon they'll say you've got cancer. So I'm praying for you that Jesus must heal you.
Amen.
You hear me?
Amen.
She's free.
Ma, please tell us your name and tell us where you come from.
My name is Hazel Nyama. I'm coming from Davidson.
Today during the service, Prophet Andrew Semono located you and he spoke upon your life. I'd love that you please tell us what he said to you and please confirm it.
Prophet Andres located me. He said I have a pain, which is a pain on my breast, which is true. It's been a while and I've been experiencing the very same pain. Yeah.
How long have you been experiencing this pain, if you do remember, and how has it affected you?
I think if I can think well, since this year, yeah, I've been experiencing it. And it's like sometimes it's moving, you know, from my left to the right or to the left, from the left to the right. Yes.
And how has it affected you?
It has been affecting me. Like sometimes I'll feel like I'm losing my breath. Yeah, because it's like a sharp pain, yeah, when it happens, yeah.
And how do you feel that today the man of God located you and he ministered upon your life?
I'm blessed because, you know, it's not the first time that Prophet Andres located me, yes, about this pain. And I'm quite sure that today I am healed.
Lot of problems.
So now,
saying that you need to learn to tolerate and pray.
Yes.
Because there are many times where you are thinking maybe to end this thing can be good.
Yes, always.
No?
Always, I always think about this, but I've been tolerating, like you said.
You're saying what? Huh?
I've been tolerating.
That's what I'm telling you.
Yes.
Because I see you alone, that, and I see the way you are crying.
Yes.
So now I want to pray for you that God must bring peace to you. Because according to what I'm seeing, you're supposed to be God.
Yes, long time.
There are many times you say, let me pack my bags and leave.
Yes.
So now let's pray for peace.
Amen.
You hear me?
Yes.
I believe Jesus must bring peace in your house.
Amen.
Ma'am, kindly please tell us your name and tell us where you come from.
My name is Kuchelushilo from Tembisa.
Today during the service, Prophet Andre Simona located you and he ministered upon your life. Kindly please tell us what he said to you and please confirm.
Okay, the man of God asked me, where's my husband? I said, he's home in Popo. And he said he must pray for my marriage for peace because as long I've been tolerating, that which is true.
And how long has this been happening and how has it affected you?
It has been happening for quite a long time and it has affected me so bad. Yes. In fact, I could say I was tired. Many times I wanted to pack my bags and go.
And how do you feel that today the man of God located you and he ministered upon your life?
I feel better and good, happy. Amen.
And how would you encourage somebody who's going through marital problems like you did before you received prayer today?
I will encourage viewers to trust in God, for everything is possible with Him. Amen.
Amen.
God will grow your business.
Amen.
This is going to be something great.
Amen.
You must not feel like it's a small thing what you're doing. You know, I believe something bigger is coming.
Amen.
You hear me?
Amen.
You know, this is, it's very small, but I'm hearing that you will even have money to build a house.
Hallelujah.
Because you've got a plan of building a house.
Amen.
But the business is very slow.
Amen.
You hear me?
Amen.
How many people want to buy a cell phone here? Are you not selling cell phones?
Distributing.
You only distribute?
Yeah.
So if you can distribute to us, even me, my own is very old. So you don't want iPhone. my own is very old. Eh? Oh, brother, I must see you after church. Everyone who's supposed to be must have a new phone.
Amen.
Sir, kindly please tell us your name and tell us where you come from.
Okay, my name is Stephen Marco. I'm staying here in Clayville, around Tembisa site.
Today during the service, Prophet Andre Simono located you and he ministered upon your life. I'd love that you please tell us what he said and please confirm it.
Prophecy was, he was telling me about the business that I was doing before, and that business it was not going well. So, but I was not doing that business full time. It was my part time because there's other job that I'm doing. So that prophecy is true. And then he said, you see me building a house. I've got a stand in Limpopo. And then I finished, so I'm stuck to build that house in, because I moved now to the new house here in Clayville. So the prophecy is true. I'm just waiting. Thank you.
And so how do you feel that today the man of God located you and he ministered upon your life regarding a business and even you finishing the house that you started at home?
It's very true, but I was very confused because he said something is coming big. But as I look at myself, so I don't have anything to grow up for building my house. Yeah, but it's true.
How do you feel that today you are located and the man of God ministered upon your life? How do you feel that today you got a prophecy? How does that make you feel?
I was feeling very good. It was very good that I just feel something is going to happen in my spirit. Yeah. Today, that's why I just decided to wait until the church is gone. It's child time.
Amen.
All right.
Let me hear you. Let me hear you, sister, you hear things.
Yes.
There's a voice that is telling you very bad things.
Yes.
So now I'm counseling because this is a spirit, a suicidal spirit on you.
Yes.
I'm seeing that sometimes you are hearing that you need to kill yourself.
Yes.
Because nothing is working out.
Yes.
This suicidal demon must leave you now. Yes. Come out! Come out, you demon! After I pray for you, things will work out. Come out! You see, suicidal demon, come out! When I look at this lady, she hear that, kill yourself. Nothing is working. Come on, you demon! Can I get a help there? Bring her here for the last time. That one. My sister, things will move.
Yes, it's true.
No more struggling.
Okay.
No more safari. Okay.
Thank you, Jesus.
Things will move in Jesus' name. She's free.
Ma'am, kindly please tell us your name and tell us where you come from.
I'm Donna Mava, so from Bushbuckers, but I reside at Ivory Tree now.
Today during the service, Prophet Andrew Simona located you and he ministered upon your life. Please tell us what he said and please confirm it.
He said that my things are not moving. It's true, my things are not moving. When I'm planning to do things, I end up not doing it. I was planning to be having my own house by now, but I don't have my house. I don't have a house. I'm not married. That's it.
And how long have you been experiencing stagnation, and how has it affected you?
It's affected me a lot because I'm the first born at my family, but my younger sister and my younger brother have things, and I don't have anything there. My younger sister just married before me, and I'm not married. It's affecting me a lot. Yes.
And how do you feel that today the man of God located you and he spoke upon your life?
Very, very happy. I'm very happy because I know that the man of God, when the man of God speak about something like this, which means it will come to pass.
Amen.
I will receive my blessings. I don't know what were blocking my blessings. I for sure is certain, but I'm sure that I'm free from now on.
Amen.
Amen.
My children, yes, the second one, but the first one is just missing.
I'm seeing a child that disappeared.
Yes, that is true. It's long time, 10 years.
10 years.
Yeah.
This thing, it must come to an end.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
As soon as possible.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. We've been waiting for this time because long
now,
time.
You see, I passed.
Yes.
And when I pass, I pray for your past. God say I must tell you about the child that disappeared.
Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
That God wants to bring a solution to this problem.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Chikwembu. You know, Because sometimes we need to ask God, should I speak or should I pass? And the issue of his son. The issue of his son, it has been sitting on his heart. Because I see this lady, sometimes she cry and say, God, can't you just reveal if my son is dead? Let us really find this thing, if he's alive or not. The question is that, are you ready to know what happened?
Yes.
Huh? Yes. Let us stretch our hands and let's pray. As I said, I wanted to pass. God said, ah, this man, his son has disappeared. Yes, and let's pray for him. This thing, they must receive conclusion. They must receive conclusion. There's nothing that is too hard for God. There's nothing that is impossible for God. I can't hear you, amen. If you believe him, he can reveal himself to you. If he is Jesus, when we cry, you will come to our rescue. I don't know if you are hearing me. Open your mouth and pray for this family. More than 10 years, a child. Let's find a solution. Pray. Just 1 minute. Just 1 minute. There's this pain in my heart. This is painful. Let's pray and see if there won't be an answer. Pray, just 1 minute. Full of wrong people around me.
Amen. Yes.
Do you hear me? You need to be careful about wrong people around you.
Amen.
Because when I look at you, I just saw people that are not living right. Amen. Do you hear me?
Amen.
So you are ready to live far away from these people?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, I'm ready to live far from. I'm ready to live far from them.
Yes. Because you know, when I touch him, I started to ask myself, I said, this man, if he does not pray, he will end up being arrested.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm telling you.
Amen.
I'm telling you, you know how your friends are living? You know some of them how they are living?
Yes, I do.
Huh?
I know how they live, some of them. I do. I know.
You know. Know with what I'm telling you. You see, I'm coming for the third time. I prayed for you, I left. I prayed for you and I left again. And I'm coming for the third time. Because I want his life to change. I'm just concerned about him. Look what is happening. Everything about him is a mess. You know, at his age, he cannot even find, he doesn't have a stable life.
It's true, man of God.
Oh.
It's true.
Yeah?
It's true, man of God.
Yes. The minute I touch you, I just saw jail. I said, why am I seeing that? It's like you will take wrong decision.
Always I do.
Thank you, Jesus.
Huh?
Like always, everything I touch, like it's a mess.
I can't hear you.
Always I make wrong decision. Everything I touch, it's like become a mess.
I love it, the way he say, because his heart is open. As I'm saying, I touch you. In my heart, I was saying to God, should I tell him or should I pass? I came, I'm still here, I'm still waiting. I pray for you, I left. I came back. I'm still waiting to hear God that, you know, should I speak with you or leave you? Because when I touch him, I just saw people and I saw a very rough lifestyle.
And it's true, man of God.
Why is like, you know, these people, when they want to make you a criminal. That's what I was seeing.
Thank you, Lord.
And if you come to church like this, it means God wants to set you free.
Amen.
And give you a proper job so that you can also succeed like other people.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
I'm sure you're hearing me.
I hear you. Yes, I do.
Some of your friends, they've got guns. Did they tell you?
Some I'm just suspecting, like they didn't
You're
tell me.
You're just suspecting that they might be having wrong guns.
Wrong guns, yes, I do.
Yes. You just suspect.
Yes. That one is true. That one is true, man of God.
Yes. That's what I'm telling you. I don't know you. I'm seeing you for the first time. Yes. I came here and touched you. I said, where am I seeing jail on you?
Thank you.
And I left. I was asking God, God, should I speak with him? I come again. I left again. And how many times? 3 times. And I see, the minute I touch him, I saw people close to him. And I'm seeing them holding guns. I say, why are they holding guns that they doesn't have certificates of? They don't have papers of these guns. So now if someone doesn't have a paper and he's holding a gun, is he not a criminal?
He's a criminal.
He's a criminal.
Yes.
Huh? Jesus loves you. You hear me?
Amen.
I want to pray for you. Isolate yourself from these people.
Please pray for me, man of God.
I will pray for you, but it's Jesus that will help you.
Amen.
And I want to tell you, no one is condemning you. You know, no one is better than you. Even me, I'm speaking with you. I'm not better than you. It's Jesus that is better than everyone.
Amen.
So now after I pray for you, your life will be in order. And you must give your life to Christ.
Amen.
You hear me? And there's a lot that I'm not mentioning. There's a lot I'm not saying here. You know, I can tell you too much. But what I'm trying to tell you is that Jesus loves you.
Amen.
After I pray for you, give your life to Christ. Because these people, they are concerned now.
Yes, it's true.
You know, the family is concerned. They say,
Yes.
What kind of a lifestyle are you living?
Yes, that's true.
So you live these things, you live this lifestyle. Alcohol, this, everything.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Give
your life to Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus loves you.
Sir, kindly please tell us your name and tell us where you come from.
I'm Calvin Maredi from Mamelodi.
Today during the service, Prophet KA Semono located you and he spoke upon your life. I'd love that you please tell us what he said to you and please confirm it.
The Prophet told me that he see my friends with a gun. It's a truth. My friends have a gun. I know they have. They didn't tell me, but I believe they have guns and then illegal guns. I believe that one is the truth. That's why I confess. I said, no, I know. I suspect they have guns, but they never told me.
And what else did the Prophet advise you to do?
The Prophet says I always make wrong decisions, and that's true. Every time I try to make better decisions, but it ends up becoming a wrong one.
And how do you feel that today the man of God located you and he ministered upon your life?
Yeah, right now I feel free because whatever he said is true. Because he said I want to run away from everyone, of which is true. I just brought myself a new stand from a different city because I just want to stay with my family. I don't want anyone. That's true because I want to run from everyone.
And what changes are you going to implement today moving forward?
From today, I just want to work for God. I just want to follow the voice of God. Stop making decisions that they will hurt me. Then yeah.
And how would you encourage somebody who's facing what you were facing before you received prayer and guidance today?
I will advise them, like, you have to read your Bible and come to church so that you can have the direction. Because sometimes you may think like you have a direction, but you don't have a direction. Because even me, I thought, no, I'm in a good spot. Whatever I'm doing, it's right. But at the end of the day, was not right.
Let me pray for your father. Let me pray for your father. Let's pray for your father. You know, so that God can give him more years of life.
Thank you.
You hear me?
Yes.
Because what I'm seeing is not good. Because because of his health now. So let's pray.
Yeah, he's God stroked.
Must. Yeah?
He's stroked.
His throat.
Yeah.
Yes. As I'm saying, because of his health now, this can change to be something else.
Thank you.
So, but with the blood of Jesus, God can heal him.
Thank you.
In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for healing this man. Let him give him more days of life so that his children can celebrate him and bless him more. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Thank you for this healing. In Jesus' name, amen. Go and buy him a small present.
Thank you. Thank you.
Before